So good morning everyone. In our last class, we were working on this averaging filter, okay? And we have considered this image, and you have done the filtering using the using this average filter, and the what do you call these borders were created by zero padding. Now today you do the same numerical, but the thing will be you create the border using the replication. Okay. So by now you have completed this sum. Now let us compare the two results. So with the zero padded and the when we have created the border using the zero padded values and when we have replicated the values. Now if you look into this pixel values, edge pixel value basically, of the zero padded values, you see these are 3, 4, 4, 5, 6, and if you look into the values of the replicated ones, over here, so what do you find? The values are drastically smaller in the zero padded values, and if you compare over here, the when you have replicated the values, they are more closely resembling this value, the original pixel value. So what happens is that if you do the zero padding, then what happens is that there is an excessive smoothing at the image this edges. Okay, so these are the image edge values, edge pixel values, right? Now in these edge pixel values, whenever you will try to do the averaging using the zero padding, there will be excessive smoothing over there. There will be excessive reduction in the intensity value as compared to the case when you go for the, this filling up of the borders using the replicated values. Okay, so this is one of the disadvantage of the zero padding. We will also look into the other with the other stuffs at later classes. Okay. Now, over here we have seen that the using of the replicated values to create the border provides us an better results while we are doing the averaging. Now, let us see how the changing of the filter size mask helps in getting some different types of results. Okay, so what results we can expect when we change the size of the filter mask? Okay, for that let us first create an image. Say 50 50 50. Take this image. Right. Now, after this, let us take two filter masks. So this is the first mask. So from our previous experience, we know that we will be going for, while averaging, we will be going for the replicated value. Okay, go for the replication. And then our second thing will be 1 by 25 into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let me change the color. So what are these? This is basically a 5 by 5 mask where you are doing the averaging. Right. Now let us see what is the example. What are the results you get over here. So it should be very easy. So for this one, for 3 by 3 mask, the number of borders to be created is 1, and for the 5 by 5 mask, the number of borders you have to create is 2. And we will be going for the replication of the values. Okay. So yahan pe kya hoga? In the first case, it will be 10 all across. राइट तो क्या है हमारा 3x3 मास्क है सो इट विल बी समथिंग लाइक दिस फर्स्ट एवरेजिंग क्या है ये सारे टेंस है तो इट विल बी 10 एवरीवेयर इट विल बी 10 ओके सो दिस सम इज समवट इजियर टू वर्क ऑन ओके देन यू गो टू द नेक्स्ट दिस थिंग इट विल बी इजियर वेयर देयर विल बी चेंज एट द transition points there will be change okay so at this point 150 will be there so 80 plus 50 divided by 9 right so at this point there will be some change from this point onward there will be change and another important thing over here is that whatever the values you calculate from here the these two rows these three rows and these three rows they will be symmetrical right because your image is symmetrical right so do it so you must have completed the numerical so now let's see what happens to the line profile what is a line profile Line profile is a just a intensity profiling across a pixel distance across a line. Suppose I want to do the profiling across these pixel values over here. Sorry. From here to here, I want to. Do the profiling. So what I will get? I will first draw a line. Okay. Now this is pixel 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Right. So this is distance d in pixel. Okay, and in the y-axis I will be having intensity, right? So in the original image, what I will be getting? I will be getting some values of 10, 10. Over here, it has suddenly increased to 50. It will stay 50 up to 4. Then again, it will come to 10, 10. So if I join this line, so this is my line profile of our of my original image. Okay. Next, you have done this thing. You have done the averaging using the 3x3 mask. Over there, what you have got? You must have got something like this, right? Something like this. Right, see, you check your this thing. So you must have got like this, and when you have used 5x5, say this one also was being minimized, something like this you must have got. Right, so what is happening? If you look especially in the region in 1 to 2 and 4 and 5, where there was a sharp change in the intensity, sharp change in the intensity is associated with high frequency. So the high frequency component, they were getting reduced. So your slope was larger the averaging filter marks, the slower will be the slope. That means your frequency component is decreasing. But while decreasing, your intensity level at the edges is also decreasing correspondingly. Okay. So this is the effect of your increase in the averaging mask. And greater the mask, the more strong is your this averaging. Okay. So if you look into this image, so this is your original image. Now next one is your 3x3 filter mask. Now if you look at the edges over here, it is less distinct as compared to the original image, right? Now when you use a 5x5 mask over here, what is happening? These edges, even this soft tissue to hard tissue, then background to this thing, background to your soft tissue region, all these things are getting more and more blurred. Okay, because the blurring effect, if you look over here, as you are increasing the size, it is the the averaging is taking place across a longer distance of the pixels. Right, previously if you see, when you use 3x3, it was just altering the values of 1 and 2 pixels, right? But when you increase it to 5x5, its distance of operation has also increased. Okay, so because of this, what is happening is that there is a more gradual increase in the this thing, your slope. And also the maxima at the foreground level, it is also coming down. So because of this combined effect, you are getting a more blurring into the image. Okay. So with this, we stop today.